Anyway, this mosque, my name is Khalifa. I was working for Shell International for 33 years as an advisor. Now I've retired, I come here as a to come and help here. Okay, this mosque was built 1995, opened 2001, 6 years of hard work. The reason is to have center for propagation of Islamic history and Oman history. So every part of this mosque is historical. When you come from the mosque was built 1995, opened 2001. So 6 years of very hard work. And everything is masterpiece of work, as you can see.
Yes.
When you come from the main entrance, first thing you saw the water fountain, and then some more channel there. That is there to reflect Oman irrigation system, we call Falaj. You know Falaj? So that is there, very unique in the world. The only place in the world with that system. When you come forward, you can see the steps, remember? This 40,000 square meters, with all the building is raised to keep up Oman tradition building mosques, Oman culture. Then from there you saw the ladies mosque. Very small. The ladies mosque very small. We have more women here than men in Oman. Why the place is small?
The women can pray at home.
Exactly. Because women in Islam encourage to pray at home, men encourage to be here. So that is only for emergency in there. Now inside there, the carpet from Scotland, purpose built for that area. The design on the top of that mosque, that is typical Omani ladies craftsmanship design. When they do carpet and this, that's the design, common design they use. The stone they use for cladding inside the mosque came from Jaipur, India. Everything was cut and dressed here. Then on top of that mosque, there are six domes. Did you see inside the domes? Must see beautiful mosaic work. Beautiful mosaic work. Masterpiece of work, and that was inspired by Omani, by this one, Cordoba Mosque. Then behind here, you can see there are two open areas. That is an overflow praying area because on Friday this becomes full. 6,650 people here, 750 ladies together outside. It can accommodate up to 20,000 people. Now outside there are five towers. You saw them? Why five?
Five pillars of Islam.
Muslims must follow five pillars of Islam. You only worship one God. God you cannot see. God is the heaven. Our God and Christian God are the same. You pray five times a day, irrespective of where you are in the world. You take charity. You take 2.5 of your money. You give to poor people. You fast 1 month every year, Ramadan. And then you go to Mecca for pilgrimage. If you are physically, so you know everything there. So that is how it works. Now the design of the tower, that is typical Oman air conditioning system without electricity. That was our cooling tower. That's the cooling system without, because we only had electricity in this country in 1972. 1970, before that there was nothing here. So that is the purpose of that one there. If you look behind the door, look at the doors. Everything about those doors, small one within the big one, all the craftsmanship and all the woodwork in the top here, these were inspired by Omani forts. So when you go to Nizwa, drive another half an hour to Fort Jibrin, and there you see most of this type of work. But that is very old, this is brand new. So here's the history of Oman. Carpet one piece.
One piece.
4,000. This this mosque is one of the wonders of the world. 4,263 square meters, 21 tons of wood, 28 natural colors from fruits and vegetables. Then it took 600 young ladies. No man was allowed to touch this. And from age of 17 to 25, and it took them 6 years to do the job. 4 years to do the job. So 600 young ladies took them 4 years to do the job. Wow. It has 1.7 billion, not million, billion notes. 40 on top of the finger. This freedom, there are 40 notes here. So dense in there. Now, this design you find here, it is not from the head. This is came from three parts of Iran, from Isfahan, Kashan, and Tabriz, blended together to generate this one. The dimension, this was done in Iran, the dimension of this and dimension of the top are perfect symmetrical. It's a masterpiece of work. You look up and look down. Now, not only that, if you move back a little bit here, I show you something. Now, this carpet, first of all, if you look at the flowers, each flower, there are multiple flowers inside, which is very unique. And they're all interconnected. Follow the loop, they're all interconnected, all of them, which is very unique for this carpet. Now this carpet's got beige color, different flowers, blue color, different flowers, multicolor area there. To complement all this, look at the windows. Where are you going to see this? Each window has got a unique color and design according to the page. Beige for beige, blue for blue, multicolor. This is just to complement this area. Let's move. Any questions? I'm here.
Just amazed.
Yeah, no, this is one of the most beautiful walls with history.
Yeah.
Now let us look at all this marble here. This white marble came from Carrara, Italy. Okay, this is the best marble you can get, white one. And everything was cut and dressed here according to the measure of the place. Decorated the area. You can see masterpiece of art, marble work all over the area. Now this chandelier, Swarovski, they're all Swarovski.
Okay.
That is 8 tons of Swarovski.
Yep,
this one, 8 meters by 14 meters. That is 2-bedroom, 5-floor building. Yes.
Yes.
1,122 light bulbs.
Yep.
So now go and take the picture under the tip. The design of this and the dome are perfect symmetrical. You have to be a good photographer. Right under the tip.
I have to lie down to
the So that's going to be there now. Now this dome, that's gold plated. That is 23.8% gold from Germany. All of them. That one. So there we've got 1,122 light bulbs. Look at the beautiful design work.
Yes.
Look at that one. Very intricate
design
work. Now, dome, this is the biggest man-made, stand-alone, mosaic dome in the world. But you know it's mosaic.
Yes,
so every piece had to be put there.
Yeah,
that,
yeah,
yes, that was inspired by one of the very famous domes in Isfahan, right? That is called Sheikh Al-Fala Dome. And that is called four designs. You see the first, the flat, the three, the triangle, and the border. And this is a typical Swarovski design, a combination of Esther Green and Magadha's design. All that is historical work. Look, beautiful artwork. You spend a lot of time just to look at that there. Okay, let us move.
Okay.
Then you can come back and take photos.
Yeah, okay.
And if you go to Iran, this will be on that on top of the dome there.
Okay.
But here, but very tiny. Yeah, this is 20 times bigger than what you want to see in Iran. I've been there twice.
Are
typical Islamic decoration of 4th to 6th century, called Mamluk design, not in there. Now, if you look at this area, now Muslims have got two set of pillars. The one you must do, the one you must believe. The one you must do, we just mentioned to you. You have to do this, and that. You know, you worship only to declare one God, pray, and this stuff. And the other one is that you must believe the pillar of faith. Which is, you know, you only worship one God, you must believe there's only one God, you have to believe all the prophets. This is very close to Christianity, the other one. And believe of angels, you believe all the books given to Moses, to Jesus, and the last and final books given to Muhammad, also given to David. So we have no objection to those books, but the last and final book is the Quran. And the last and final prophet is Muhammad. So all the 25 prophets previously mentioned the Bible, also mentioned the Quran. But the last and final prophet is Muhammad. We believe of divine preordainment. Anything happens to you in this world, God has written it to test you. So don't kill yourself. Just be patient. And then one day we'll all die. Those who are dead are sitting on the bench there waiting for us. We'll all gone, all of us, then we'll all be resurrected. Then God will judge us accordingly. Good things, definitely you go to heaven. Bad news, you go to hell with politicians. Yeah. Okay, where do you come, where, what religion are you?
Sorry, we are Buddhist.
Buddhist, okay. All right, let us move. Okay, this area, this is facing Mecca. You are no Christian here, okay? In Mecca there's a cube. That cube was built by one of the prophets called Abraham. Mm-hmm. The prophet was inspired by God through Angel Gabriel. If you know about Islam, Christian, you understand this. And then after building it, God instructed that prophet Abraham through Angel Gabriel to go around it. We are doing it today. Mm-hmm. Now, every Muslim face is there. We don't worship it. Mm-hmm. We don't worship objects. Mm-hmm. We worship God Almighty, the heaven. That's why no picture here. If you put a small picture here of a creature, nobody will come to pray here because we are very pure monotheism religion. Mm-hmm. So we only worship God in the heaven. So this area only for the, we face Mecca just for unity of praying. Mm-hmm. Nothing, we don't worship it. Mm-hmm. Now why is that shape? Mm-hmm. Any reason? 1,000 years ago, I mean 700 years ago, there was no microphone speaker.
Wow. Acoustic.
Acoustic purpose.
Yeah. Okay.
So this is a very old design. Mm-hmm. Now this, when Muslims pray, we don't look at each other. Mm-hmm. Everybody faces Mecca. Mm. So when the Imam stands there reading the Quran, we want to hear what he's reading.
Yeah.
Yeah, because yeah. Islam is only religion yeah. on earth where the ritual of prayers and language of prayer is the same all over the world. Yeah. Mm. When you stand there, you can only read what is written in the Quran. You know Quran. Mm. Yes. Quran is now 1,400 years old, intact. Mm. Not a dot has changed. Mm-hmm. The only book which is compatible to science. We get free copy in our information center. And then, every single Muslim in this world has memorized that book. 600 pages, either partially or fully. Mm-hmm. And then 17 times a day, when we come here, 5 times a day, 17 prayers, mm-hmm. the Imam will read from that Quran. We don't know which area is going to start, because 600 pages, mm-hmm. he can choose whatever he wants.
Yeah.
But as soon as he starts and makes a mistake, we jump and correct him instantaneously. Yeah, he cannot bring new stories here. The only religion on earth.
Yeah.
If he collapses, we push him one side, somebody else continues the business. Business as usual in Islam. Yeah. Now, so we don't have a priest. Mm. We don't have a Buddha. We don't have anything. Every single Muslim is a priest. Mm. I can go to Japan or China or Singapore or anywhere in the world and lead the prayers. Mm. Any foreigner can come here and lead the prayers. Mm. Because the only religion on earth where everything is the same all over the world. So whenever we come here 5 times a day, we ask each other who's going to lead the prayer. Mm-hmm. So it could be Chinese, Russian, Indian, American, standing there. Because the ritual is the same. Very unique religion. Now all this here, now there are two designs here, normally only see one of them. Either this or that one. They put two of them here to show two common designs. See, this is one with flat design, which is called Rasmi Bandi, and a grid. That is all for the sound. From the very big grid to a peak of 10. So the amount calculation required to come up to that conclusion up there is tremendous. And this is 700 years ago. Muslims are very good in calculation many years ago, not now. Now we only want big cars and walking around. And there are two doors here. Can you see the door there?
Oh, yes. Yeah.
If you don't see the door, you have to go see the doctor, your optician again.
Oh, yes.
So that they're only for the sultan. When sultan comes here, he walks in, and comes and pray here. Unfortunately, he only came the day to inaugurate the place, and the day he died, he saw that day. So now the Imam uses there. Now here, anybody can do Islam, anybody can lead prayer. And there, on Friday, an expert will come and stand there, learn as a Muslim, and just remind us about our social responsibility. No, don't drink and drive. Don't drive too fast on an accident. Because if you drive very fast and die during an accident, then you suicide. You smoke cigarettes. If you get cancer and die, you commit suicide. You drink alcohol and you get an accident, you die, you commit suicide. You go to hell in Islam. You are fully responsible and accountable whatever you do. Nobody can save you in this world. We are only here temporary, and the reason we are here is to worship one God, to prepare for the other world. So you need to do everything here, and every single human being is fully responsible and accountable. No helper will come down there when you reach there. So that man was telling us about our responsibility. Every Friday, he reminds us about one subject. And 2 weeks ago, it was about care of the parents. In Islam, after God Almighty, is your mother and father. Mother carries 75% of the weight, father only 25%. So the paradise in Islam is under the feet of your mother, not father. So if you can repay father, you can never repay your mother. So you don't take care of them, then don't come and waste your time. You go to hell. Whatever we have belonged to our parents until they die. So you don't shout at them, you don't push them around, do everything, until they die, because that is one of the gates of going to the paradise in Islam. Now, you see the design outside there? Outside this mosque, the design outside the mosque, the typical Omani fort design. The stone from there, they bring the stone from Jaipur, and the stone they put around the mosque, cladding around the mosque, is called Arabic design. The same stone, dark color one, on the corridor there, that is called Tilak, called Taj Tilak design. There. But everything came from Jaipur, India. This is sandstone from there. Everything was cut here. The design behind the windows, can you see that one? The design behind the windows? 55 Rajasthanis were brought here from India. It took them 5 years to do all that by hand. Everything by hand here, everything masterpiece of work. You won't see again, even Japan you won't see. Beautiful flowers, but nothing else there. So when you finish, you can go outside there, the long corridors, beautiful mosaic work from all over the world. Something you need to spend 2 hours there. When you finish everything, you go to our information center. At the center there, information center there. They'll get Omani coffee, Omani dates, Omani water, free. Any books, in any language, you get there free. We give to non-Muslim. Any questions? Anything goes here. No question.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. It's just amazed. We're just like absorbing everything.
There's a lot to see here. Beautiful place. The most beautiful mosque in the world. A lot to see in here.
It's a get-go coming. Wow.
Yeah, I was in Malaysia only two.